Hello. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up conversion tracking for your Google AdWords campaigns. Hello, I'm Uzair and thanks for joining in. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your conversion tracking. It is one of the most important aspects before you start any campaigns, because if you don't, then you won't know what is working and what isn't. And when you're setting up your conversion tracking, we also need to define what is a conversion. If you are selling something online with an e-commerce website, then perhaps a purchase is a conversion. Whereas if you have a lead generation website and you are generating leads, then a lead could be a conversion when someone fills in a form. Or you could set up conversion for a phone call to be made to you. So through Google AdWords, we can track phone calls as well. So there's a variety of call to actions which can be classified as a conversion. A conversion could be a downloadable PDF or any other call to action which you have set up on your website. So it is extremely important that you set up conversion tracking before a campaign is started. So let's head off to our interface and I'll show you how you set up the conversion tracking. So you go in the menu, go to conversions, click the plus button. Now obviously I've set one up already in my test account, so I'm gonna set up a new one. Now in here, you've got a choice. What is a conversion? Whether it is for a website to track sales or any other call to actions on your website. Is it an app download or an install, a phone call, or an import from any other system, from your CRM system, if you have one, so you can do that as well. But we're gonna stick to the website one for this video. So we're going to call it lead generation via form. So you can call it whatever you like. The next step is to select a category, whether it is a purchase or a sale, sign up lead or anything else. So I'm going to just say a lead. Now in here, most people, when they set up a conversion tracking, they don't put up a value. And I would highly recommend that you do put up a value. Obviously, if it's a conversion for an e-commerce website, then you want to know how much is the value of each conversion. So if you were to click this button for use the same value for each conversion in the case of lead generation, then all you do is change your currency. And let's say the value of each lead which we generate is 50. So then Google AdWords will keep track of your values in here and then you can work out your ROI on AdWords. If you are running an e-commerce website or an e-commerce shopping campaign of some kind, then you will select this option where you are using different values for each conversions. But for this, you will need to edit the conversion tag with a bit of JavaScripting. So you will need to speak to your web developer or somebody who has got a bit of knowledge and know-how as to how to edit these conversion tracking codes. Or the third option is don't use a value, but I won't recommend you do that. So even if you don't know the value of your lead conversion, just set it to 1, but don't keep it to 0. All right, so I'll keep it at 50. Then we have the count. Select how many conversions to count per click or interaction. So you got every, which is recommended for online purchases. So if someone clicks your ad and then makes 3 purchases, that will count as 3 conversions in AdWords. Whereas the 1 option is if someone clicks your ad and then fills in a form three times, then the AdWords will still will only count as a single conversion. So for the lead generation, we're going to select one. Conversion window is how long to track the conversion after an ad is clicked or any other kind of interaction. So you've got up to 90 days, or you can have custom days up to 90 days. Usually I tend to keep up to 30 days. So if somebody saw your ad, clicked on it and did not convert, but after, let's say on day 28, they came back to your website and converted, Google AdWords is going to classify that as a conversion. But if they came back to your website on day 31, because they came back after the conversion window period, it won't be classified as a conversion. So you can decide whether you wish to keep it up to 90 days. It really depends on how long your lead time is, or the days to conversion is. So in some niches and industries, the conversion, the days to conversions is very short, whereas in some industries, it's a lot longer. For example, finance, where somebody is applying for a loan, unless it is for in an emergency, they will convert very quickly once they have found the bank or the finance house. Or in the case of, let's say, a mortgage, when buying a house, the conversion rate, the days to conversions could be quite long, because you're not going to make a decision about getting a mortgage within a day or two. So you're going to convert over a longer period of time. So in that case, I would keep the days to conversion a bit longer. Then we've got the view through conversion window. Select how long to track your view through conversions after an impression. So if somebody saw your ad and did not convert, then you can set this up. I would then keep it to 30 days. Include conversions. Including conversions, you always check that one. And because then your conversion is going to show in your conversions column. And if you were to use smart bidding, your bid strategies will optimize for these conversions as well. Attribution model, every company attributes differently. Some attribute linearly, where they have attributed the conversion to all the various clicks across the board, whereas some may attribute towards the first click. I usually tend to go on the last click, and if you're not sure about the attribution model, then just set it up to the last click. And once you've done all that, you create and continue. Then you will come to this page where you've got two tags. One is the global site tag, and the other one is the event snippet tag. So the first one is copy the tag below and paste it in between the head tags of every page of your website. And you only need to install this global tag once per account. So I would highly recommend using Google Tag Manager for installing and keeping track of all your tags, be it AdWords, analytics, Facebook, or any other kind of tracking codes you need to install. It's a great piece of software which is free to use, and you can keep all your tags in one place. If you're not sure about how to install this, again, give it to your web dev and you can download the snippet from here, and they'll be able to install it for you. The second tag is the event snippet tag. And what you need to do is you need to add this to a page that a customer reaches after completing a conversion. So this does not go on all the pages throughout your website. That is very important. So once someone fills in a form and they go to a certain page, like a thank you or a confirmation page, then you add that snippet on that page and not on the webs on all the pages of the of your website. Otherwise, your conversion tracking, everybody who comes to your website will be classified as a conversion, and that again goes between your head tags of the page or pages you'd like to track right after the global site tag. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you would like me to create similar videos like this one, please put in the comments box below and I'll do my best to create a video for you. Thank you for your time. I really appreciate it, and I look forward to seeing you soon in my next video. Bye for now.